Our goal with iqClock is to bring the best clocks in the world to society.
Clocks. Everyone has one. Some are very precise, some less so. Here at the University of Amsterdam, Florian Schreck leads a consortium that has as its goal to build the most precise clocks in the world.
We are bringing one of the best types of clocks in the world from the lab to industry. Usually, these clocks fill a large laboratory. They cannot be transported and several PhD students are needed to operate them. By contrast, our clock will only be as big as two large fridges and it will work on the push of a button. This will make it possible to use our clock to synchronize a cell phone network. In parallel, we are developing a completely new type of clock. The so-called active optical clock is kept ticking by atoms emitting laser light on an ultra-narrow optical transition. This is fascinating physics. And in the future, it might allow us to build even more precise or compact clocks. I'm excited about the iqClock project and I enjoy very much encountering a lot of interesting people while working on it.
The best clock in the world. It will be so precise that if you would have turned it on 14 billion years ago, when the universe came into existence, it still would be off by less than a second. Such an enormous effort requires a large consortium of universities and industry partners. At the University of Birmingham, Yeshpal Singh is one of the coordinators of the iqClock Consortium.
At the University of Birmingham, we are co-leading iqClock project as part of European Quantum's flagship initiative. As part of iqClock project, we are building an optical lattice clock in collaboration with our European partners, including industry collaboration.
Besides Amsterdam and Birmingham, four more universities are involved. While in Birmingham, the goal is to make existing clocks smaller and better. In Copenhagen and Torun, researchers work on an entirely new type of quantum clock.
Here at the Niels Bohr Institute, we work on a so-called super radiant laser. This can allow faster timekeeping and improve the performance of quantum sensing.
At Nicolaus Copernicus University in Torun, we work on super radiance phenomenon. We'll design a continuous active optical clock with strontium atoms.
Experiment and theory go hand in hand. The iqClock theorists are located in Austria, in Vienna and Innsbruck.
The role of the University of Innsbruck in the iqClock project is to provide theoretical support and numerical calculations. This includes investigations of novel Planck mechanisms for clock atoms, as well as performing simulations for the experimental teams in Amsterdam, Copenhagen and Torun in order to predict operational parameters feasible in experiments.
For this, we use our very own simulation framework called quantumoptics.gl, amongst other tools that we are currently developing in the Julia programming language.
My name is Georgy Kazakov. Here at Vienna, we study theoretically various implementations of a so-called bad cavity laser. Our main aim is to investigate different real-life effects that unavoidably take place in real experiments. Understanding the role of these effects is crucial for the iqClock project.
Yeshpal Singh explains why the iqClock project is not just an academic endeavor.
One of the things that we are trying to do is de-risking the reliance over GPS. If GPS is lost for some reason, then European economy will lose more than €1 billion per day from its economy, because at the moment Europe economy 8 to 10% of its GDP does depend on GPS and its services.
The six universities joined forces with six companies all throughout Europe. Five of these helped develop the many different components of the clocks.
Here at NKT Photonics, we contribute to the iqClock project by supplying photonic crystal fibers that deliver the widely separated wavelengths that are vital for the quantum clock.
Aktar is working on a black light absorbing coating for the vacuum chamber for iqClock.
Hi, I'm Tony Flavin from Kronos Technology. We're a small company that's been developing timing and synchronization solutions since 1986, and we're developing the measurement solution for iqClock.
Teledyne E2V creates specialized components and subsystems for several different industry branches. Within iqClock, the company will develop the vacuum and control system for the integrated optical lattice clock.
Hello, I'm Rafał Wilk from Toptica Photonics. We develop laser system to slow down the atoms, catch them, keep them cool, and to read out optical clock transition. We develop frequency comp too, that will be used to keep all the lasers locked and to transfer optical frequency stability down to radio frequencies. It will be useful for 5G communication and beyond.
Finally, the goal is, of course, to start using these ultra-precise clocks, for example, in very well-synchronized telecom networks. This is why telecommunications multinational BT is also involved.
Here at BT, we will test the performance of the new clock in a real-life environment. A very precise clock is important for us, because every component of the network need to be accurately synchronized to work at its best.
12 partners all over Europe, united in their goal to make the best clock in the world.
Building clocks is not only very useful, you learn also a lot of physics, and that's fun.
Do you want to know more about how these ultra-precise clocks are made and what physics is involved? Visit iqclock.eu or watch our YouTube entertainment series on Clocks and Time.